Welcome to this episode of Star Wars Declassified, where we look into different facts and stories revolving around the Star Wars canon universe and lore. In today's Declassified, we'll be looking at the Imperial Security Bureau, the secret police of Emperor Palpatine during the reign of the Galactic Empire. Officially, the ISB was the law enforcement and intelligence agency of the Galactic Empire that was in charge with matters of state security with ensuring the loyalty of citizens to the Empire. However, its main role behind the scenes was as Palpatine's secret police organization, dedicated to rooting out the enemies of the New Order and maintaining stability throughout the Imperial territories shortly after the proclamation of the New Order. Thus, not only were civilians, pirates, rebels targeted, but as well Imperials themselves whom the ISB identified as a threat to the Empire. To accomplish this, the ISB stationed moles amongst the officers of all capital ships in the Imperial Navy, whose duty was to report on any possible treasonous activities or sentiments present among others of the ship's crew. Any suspects were audited by the ISB and then afterwards interrogated and executed. Prior before that, the ISB's main role was being responsible in wiping out any memories to that of the Jedi Order, but as well in helping oversee the dismantling of the Confederate warships and any martial supplies from the Clone Wars. Not only was the ISB in charge of removing all known existing Confederate military equipment, but as well silencing and purging any remaining separatist propaganda. This resulted in any artist caught continuing in creating separatist propaganda to be raided by the ISB, and then later sentenced to execution. Former Republic officer Wolf Yularen was a part of the ISB leadership, together with Deputy Director Harris Eisen. And as one of the main highest-ranked ISB officials, he personally oversaw the training of the cadets at the ISB Academy in the Verity District on Coruscant. The cadets there went through a training regiment which included the learning of xenophobic propaganda, and were taught from the ISB Loyalty Manual, and as well as specialized vocabulary to prevent outsiders from understanding their conversations. Afterwards, the graduated cadets would be placed in one of the 8 different branches of the ISB, being surveillance, interrogation, re-education, enforcement, investigation, internal affairs, special operations, and advanced weapons research. One of the top ISB cadets was of course Alexander Callus, who worked in both the investigation and internal affairs branches, and searched for signs of disloyal activity or insurgency. His primary mission was to ensure it did not spread to the full-scale rebellion against the Empire, and was tasked with eliminating the Lothal Base Spectre's rebel cell. Due to the different roles within the ISB, there were also uniform distinctions. This being that the ISB agents who worked in the field like Callus wore a modified Imperial officer uniform with light armor and a helmet. Meanwhile, ISB officers were best known by wearing a standard Imperial officer uniform, but with the exception of a white jacket with an ISB rank. After the Battle of Endor and the death of Emperor Palpatine, while majority of the Empire decided to go in their own direction, the ISB were one of the few who continued to remain loyal to the Emperor. In fact, the ISB were not only in charge of keeping Operation Cinder confidential and carrying it out, but were also given the full oversight under the security of Coruscant. After the Imperial Navy refused to provide ships to defend the planet, with Fleet Admiral Gallius Rax viewing it as a waste of resources and a pointless effort. While the ISB lacked the ships to effectively withstand eventual New Republic naval assault, ISB loyal stormtroopers and personnel continued to remain on the planet to fight in a civil war between the ISB and the New Republic-backed resistance movements, which would last until 5 ABY with the declaration of the Galactic Concordance, and officially put an end to the existence of the ISB. And that will do it for this episode. If you enjoyed what you saw, please like and share it, along with subscribing to the channel to not only support it, but keep up with Star Wars news, gaming, and canon lore released every week. And consider following me on Twitter and Facebook to never miss out on the latest Star Wars related content. And if you want to support the channel, do check out our Patreon page. Or if you want to continue the conversation, join us on the official Silo Discord server. Thanks for watching, and may the Force be with you. You